everyone. I'm Larry Ridley. You're tuned in to the NFL on EA Sports. In today's game, we have a divisional matchup in the AFC West. It's the young gun, Derek Carr, going up against the old veteran, Philip Rivers. With that, let's get you out to San Diego. Here are Brandon Guyton and Charles Davis.
Okay, Larry, we are a little less than 10 miles inland from the blue waters of the Pacific Ocean as we greet you from lovely San Diego, California. Tonight, we've got a good AFC matchup on tap between the Oakland Raiders and the San Diego Chargers. And he'll get it up to about the... six-yard line just across the 25. And the D-line pinching together must be expecting the run. They come out here in the eye. Now Carr going to give to Olawale. Just a yard on the first down carry, so it's second and nine.
That's someone who's pretty happy right there. That's the defense coordinator. Body after body getting to him before he can get started.
Walford in motion, the tight end. Now a first carry for Latavius Murray. And this one goes nowhere. Losing yardage back at the 22.
And frankly, Brandon, we're talking about things I'm not sure we ever thought we'd talk about in the NFL. And a lot of that is the speed at the linebacker position. A lot of these guys in college, they were safeties. They moved them up to outside linebacker to combat the spread offenses. And now we're seeing it in the NFL, those same guys using their speed to make plays in the backfield, similar to that one.
And he'll have his man. That's Cooper. And they're going to get this one all the way out across the 45. He's such a good route runner. Shows it there on third down. Very proficient and a good pass.
And you know what I've observed over the years in the NFL? The better a route runner you are, the more confidence your guy's going to have in you to go to you in important times, because he can trust you being in the right spot, and they connected there and picked up a first down.
And got his man complete. And all the way in. Touchdown, Oakland. Amari Cooper, 52 yards. And the Raiders have taken the early lead. And that makes it 7-0 Oakland. Now Janikowski following the score. He'll boot this one away. And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. Here on this first play as he gets it to the line of scrimmage and no more. Tackle made by Perry Riley. Time to get a glance at the offensive starters, and one of those isn't J.J. Watt, but it's Derek Watt that we talk about.
Nothing wrong with being little bro here. A starting fullback at the University of Wisconsin. Not many teams are utilizing this position in the NFL, but he fits perfectly. Will be a great lead blocker and can catch the ball out of the backfield.
It'll be a gain of 8 yards, and that'll make it third and one.
It's interesting because when I'm watching college football and I'm evaluating guys for the draft now, my list of fullbacks, pure fullbacks, it's a very short list. I'm probably evaluating more punters and kickers now than I am fullbacks. But doesn't matter what you call the position, it's who you put there, and there we saw completion. Well, the person carrying the ball is always the easy target when things aren't going so well. But I think it's a combination with the Chargers. They've got to get the offensive line going in order to improve those numbers from last year. They weren't very good running it, partner.
No, they were bottom of the AFC, second to last in the entire NFL. They'll run for it. It's Gordon. And some room to maneuver. There goes Melvin Gordon. Past the 20. And all the way in. Touchdown. San Diego. Melvin Gordon, 66 yards. And the Chargers are an extra point away from tying this thing up. Josh Lambeau now for the point after. It's good, and we're all tied at 7 apiece. So we're right back where we started. All even as the kick's away. Here's Tywan Jones on the return. The Raiders offense now, they trot back out, and they were able to punch it in the end zone last time. They'll be looking to do that again here for the defense. Obviously, they'll be looking to stop them from punching it back in the end zone.
It always is punch-counterpunch, isn't it? And which team has the advantage? Well, let's just go back. Last time on offense, they rolled downfield, got into a good rhythm. You can see a little more bounce in and out of the huddle. You can see the sideline really get into the game. So defensively, you're thinking to yourself, how do we take that away from them? How do we get the advantage back? Let's see what they come up with. I think pressure is always the first way to go.
You love pressure.
I love it.
We'll see if they dial it up this drive. And for that man, Crabtree just finished his eighth NFL season. Of course, the first six in San Fran, last two with the Raiders. Barely topped the 1,000-yard mark, but he did 1,003 this season.
It's been interesting to watch the career arc of Michael Crabtree, because you remember when he came out of college, came out of Texas Tech, he was seen as a pure number one receiver. Many thought he was going to be a future All-Pro, but he settled in as the number two guy in Oakland, and I think that's been great for him, taking the pressure off of Amari Cooper and making plays himself.
Finds Roberts left side. And all the way in. Touchdown, Oakland. Seth Roberts, 47 yards, and the Raiders have taken the lead. Great corner route there, not only able to catch it, turn it upfield, and get into the end zone.
It usually involves a little bit of an extra move, doesn't it? You've got to get them thinking that you're moving to the middle of the field and you're breaking away to that corner. Boy, that was well executed.
Janikowski following the score. He'll boot this one away. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. And now San Diego getting set to go. And they're hoping to capture some of that magic they had last time out when they were able to put together a scoring drive. But they're still down here, Charles.
Not the major concern, though, because of what you talked about. They scored the last time out. They feel good about themselves. They feel like their game plan is now in effect. They know how to attack and what plays they want to put together. But they've got to keep it moving in the right direction because, as you did note, they are down on the scoreboard.
They'll roll him out right. On the run, he'll let this go deep. And that's caught inside the 35. And all the way in. Touchdown, San Diego. Keenan Allen, 75 yards. And the Chargers are an extra point away from tying this thing up. And that is how you retaliate after getting scored on one play, big pass downfield, and you hit the end zone.
Almost feels like two boxers just throwing haymakers at each other, doesn't it? One connects with a big one, the other comes right back. Okay, I'll show you. And they attacked right back on the first play of the drive and hit them big.
This will be taken in at the one. And he'll take it past the 25 and up to the 28-yard line. And now Oakland ready to take the field. And that recipe on their last drive that resulted in a touchdown looked pretty good, so they'll be hoping to do that once more.
And it takes me back to when we sat with the offensive coordinator and the head coach. They felt pretty good about their game plan, and Thought there were some holes in the defense, and they exploited them the last time out. Let's see if they can come back and put together a similar drive.
And we'll see if they can do just that. They go play action here on first down. Backing up. Oh, a battle for it here, and this will be caught. He got 29 yards that time.
And they pick up a first down, and that came out of the fullback position. But as you and I both know, that doesn't necessarily mean it's a fullback playing in that spot.
Well, times have changed, right? The old school fullback doesn't really exist anymore.
We're not getting that same player out of college. With all the spread offenses, not very many pro style, we actually have a true fullback. We're having to make do in the NFL and put guys in that spot who emulate it but aren't necessarily that position.
Murray had the 1,000-yard season in 2015, followed that up with 788 last year. Now, also in the mix in Oakland, you had Washington, you had Rashard. How do you see this backfield playing out going forward?
I think you'll see a similar combination going forward. I think that's one of the reasons that he dropped from a 1,000-yard runner to 788 because they had other options. They're able to bring in Washington, Rashard. They can use different plays for those guys, a lot of versatility, and really upgrade.
And now the ball's out. Carr lost it. Fumble. But I think the Raiders are going to be able to hold on to it. Yes.
On plays like this where the ball comes free, it's often unusual for the team that lost it to get it back. Because everyone else is trying to execute what they're supposed to do on offense. They're usually looking in the direction downfield or have moved away from it. In this case, though, the teammate is able to come up with the ball.
And that's good. 15 yards through the air on a first down.
I'll text it to you.
He's now north of 200 yards here in the first half. Boy, a tough start for the secondary defensively.
It is, and it's got to put a dent in their confidence. And, you know, you always want to keep that up.
All right. Feel
like you can always bounce back after plays. But with the kind of numbers he's putting up here, it's starting to wear on them a little bit, I think. So they're looking at each other and trying to figure out what defense will work and how can they play better without getting beat deep for big passes.
Offense still needing 10 yards. Second down. Possible run anticipation here as the D-line sandwiches together. Now Carr throwing on second down. Flushed out right. And he's got room. And a loose
football. Come on, bro.
And picked up by the Chargers.
When I see a play like that, I come back to risk reward. And I don't know about you, but is it worth it at that point, whatever you're going to pick up, to either take the hit, and in this case, lose the football play.
Should have gone down. I mean, hindsight's always 20-20, but that's the safe play.
You're exactly right. Hindsight's really never wrong, is it? Because you can analyze it, but I think ultimately you've got to look at it as a first option, taking care of the ball, getting what you can, and that's it. Don't worry about it anymore.
And partner Antonio Gates coming back for another year. It'll be his 15th season in 2017.
And how about, let's just talk about not just the longevity, but he's in a position now where he can break a tie with Tony Gonzalez because they both have 111 touchdowns at the tight end position. Antonio Gates' first touchdown of 2017, that'll break that tie. He'll be number one.
That's pretty impressive. Probably going to be playing behind Hunter Henry, second-year man, but just the sustainability, how long he's lasted in the league, impressive.
And think about this. Phillip Rivers, so excited to have him back because Hunter Henry's playing well, but Mr. Reliable is Antonio Gates.
After that big play, let's see if they can catch their defense maybe on their heels. One man in the backfield is Gordon. And he'll get it up the middle. A gain of 3, second down. And after the play on the ground, that brings up second down here.
We always like to talk about defense in terms of levels. First level defensive line, second level linebackers, third level defensive backs. On that run, that was what we call a first-level run, and it was stopped by a second-level player.
And they'll be inside the 35 now at the 34-yard line.
I know most of the time when the ball's in the air, you're thinking wide receiver, tight end, but running backs, they can be a big part of any passing offense nowadays.
They come out here in the eye. Carry for the vet, Danny Woodhead. Just a 1 yard pickup there, and it'll be fourth down. So 2 minute. To go in a wild first half. We'll come back to San Diego after this timeout. Would have been a decently long field goal, 51 yards from here, but instead they're going to go for it. Looks like the defense in press coverage here. Fourth down, Rivers. Right side catch. This is Gates. And he's going to have the first down yardage as he's down at about the 30-yard line.
Do you get the sense, Brandon, that people are trying to retire Antonio Gates? They keep thinking this is almost the end of the line, and then he keeps making catches like the one we just saw there.
He's the old reliable, you're right, just one of nine players in the NFL with 100 or more touchdowns. One man in the backfield is Gordon. Now a play fake here. Blitz coming, and down he goes. Bruce Irvin in there to make the sack. He buries him for a loss of 10.
Now, we talk about players blitzing all the time. I often laugh and sometimes call it just straight-ahead pursuit. What a running start right back to the backfield for him.
Yeah, it really didn't give anybody a chance to get up there and stop him.
No, I mean, that's really, really difficult. You're asking a whole lot anyway, but when he gets that kind of a start and comes through clean, oftentimes the advantage definitely goes to the defensive player.
Now it's a bootleg with Rivers. Caught by Gates, left side. They get 16 out of that one, but they'll still need to convert on third. So on that play, defense was in the zone. They ran a crossing route off it. Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. It's just their first, so they'll have two remaining here before we get to halftime. The eighth play of the drive coming up. It's third and three. Trying to power it ahead with one. Just a yard on the run there, and that's going to bring us to a fourth down.
Well, there's a... trust factor in that call. Turning and handing it to the big man in the backfield, trying to pick up the first down. But how about the defense? They were ready for him, and they were able to stop him.
It would be a very makeable field goal try from here, but instead they're going to go for it. They're going to run. This is Gordon. And he'll lose yardage here, going down back at the 28. Melvin Gordon unable to push his way forward. And the Raider D, they get the football back. And now Oakland ready to take the field. And with time quickly fading here in the second quarter, not sure how aggressively, offensively they want to play this.
I think we'll find out just how much they trust their guys in this situation if they decide to take a shot.
And he bats it away, and it falls down incomplete. So second and 10 here.
They decide to air it out a little bit on that play, take a shot downfield, but the coverage was really nice. Able to get a hand in and tip it away.
Over the middle, Amari Cooper, it's complete. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. So as they take it over, we step aside.
All right, here we go.
The final shot here before half for Carr. Dancing to his left. Oh, hit as he throws there, incomplete. So we've hit intermission. It's halftime. This is the NFL, and it's a presentation of EA Sports. Both teams appear ready for the fight ahead, and we resume action here in quarter number three. And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. Out comes the Chargers as they'll go on offense now, to start this third quarter. First half showed us some pretty good offense. Tie game, we'll see what the second half brings.
And it'll be interesting because I think both sides feel pretty good about what their offenses are doing. Gotta wonder what adjustments are being made defensively to try and get a spark or maybe slow down the other side.
But here, do you change up anything on this opening drive?
Not offensively, you don't. You've got everything going your way. You're probably prepared for maybe some change-ups you might expect, but overall, you like what your game plan's showing you.
And a nice carry there of 15 yards.
Whenever we meet with coaches and they always talk about wanting to establish running the football, it's oftentimes with a good tight end who can control the line of scrimmage and the point of attack, and they're becoming harder to find because the colleges are giving us a whole lot of receiving tight ends, former wide receivers who can run, not necessarily block very well. In this case, though, we saw two tight ends on the field, both of them with the ability to block, and he ran the ball successfully behind that power set.
A first down throw here for Rivers. Gates has it over the middle. And he's brought down. 12 yards on the pickup. Good enough for a San Diego first down. And the offense moving quickly to the line. They go play action here on first down. Steps away. Now he's going to let it go deep left side. This is caught inside the 15. And he had 25 yards out of that one. And it'll give the Chargers a first down. Well, we know he's got the speed there. He needed the speed and the hands. A great catch.
And because of that speed, you have to respect it as a defender. So you have to either play off or make sure you're somehow in contact with him. And he's able to do exactly what you said. Use the speed to his advantage and go up and get the football. That's a big-time play right there.
He's brought down that time by a couple of Raiders.
That was a really nice play, be able to stack that one up. When they get back in the huddle, he's got to tell his guys up front, great job. They kept people off of him, allowed him to run free and make the hit on the runner.
Filled the gap nicely, kept him to just a one-yard gain. He was looking for his tight end, Hunter Henry, and it's third down. Nine yards to go, it's third down. One receiver left, that's Allen. On third down, Rivers. That's complete, right around the 8. And the stop will come inside the 5 at the 4. It'll be a gain of 8, but it also lead to a fourth down.
He wasn't the primary target, but I think it was almost like a check down situation, wasn't it?
Yeah, hoping he can break some tackles, a big tight end, but he couldn't do it.
Yeah, get it to that big frame and hope he can scatter some bodies, unable to get it done.
Back to the ground now with Gordon. He didn't get the touchdown, but he did. Hello, get
laughing.
The first down.
Emoji smiling face with open mouth.
They come up in an offset eye. To throw is Rivers.
Come on, bro. Grab that shit.
Defenders get tired of hearing about their lack of hands and why they're playing defense instead of offense. But in this situation, it was the hands that made the play. Batting the ball away on an attempted touchdown pass. Excellent job. Way to knock it down.
What the f***?
It's the fullback taking it in.
Oh, that was some bullshit.
And that's why you have the fullback, Charles. Couldn't get it in the play before with a smaller guy. Turned a little more power. They scored.
And that has to warm the hearts of a lot of old school football fans. They love when they get to see a little bit of power football.
And Lambeau now, after the touchdown, he'll kick this one away. This will be taken in at the 1. And nice work on the return as he'll start.
There ain't no face mask on that shit.
The 30-yard line. A look at the offense now here coming back out on the road for their first possession of the second half. They trail offense, first time to touch the ball in quarter 3, and we'll see what they can do.
Are you about to get beat in Madden 170?
Because some teams.
Yep. That was a weak ass blitz, man.
The They come out five wide, three of them to the right side. Carr now to throw. Forced out to his left.
Oh my God, bruh. Fucked up.
It'll be a pickup of just two, and they're going to be staring at a third and long here.
Now, how about that play? He took a possible negative and turned it into positive yardage and slid down to avoid taking a big shot. Excellent job getting down and avoiding the big hit.
And he'll have his man. That's Cooper. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. A great job pulling that one in from a guy, as we know, who can really blaze. He's got a lot of speed.
And that speed can work for him so many different ways. Sometimes he just takes off and goes and just runs past people. Sometimes you get people to back off so far that you can catch everything underneath. But still, at some point in the game, you probably have to make some contested catches, right? Sometimes you have to go up and beat a defender for the football. He has that in his arsenal as well.
Showed it right there.
Completion was given up, but that's why you play zone defense, so that you can have people around the ball when it's caught, and you don't give up much run after the catch.
What the fuck? Why he stall like that, man? That's some bullshit, bro.
And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back.
That was some straight up bullshit, man.
Making good decisions, distributing the ball well, distributing it accurately, keeping it away from danger. A really nicely run drive.
But now the defense, what adjustments do they need to make in the passing game?
Pass rush, pass rush, pass rush. Whether it's the guys up front, or maybe you bring additional guys, but you've got to disrupt the timing of them throwing the football.
Yeah, we'll see if they can disrupt it here. Offense looking to avoid a third and long. It's second and ten. Now a 10th carry for Melvin Gordon.
Got him.
Oh, and he's not going to make it out of the end zone. The push too strong, and that'll be a safety. So, Charles, that's Exhibit A for the danger of running a toss play this close to your own end zone.
And how well was that defended? Someone was able to come up and set the edge. You can't go around him, and this time, he was left with just nowhere to go.
And remember, following the safety, you give the football up as well, and they free kick it from the 20.
Oh, shit. Why don't fucking fair catch that shit?
And now Oakland ready to take the field. Interception last time on the opponent's side of the field, certainly not what they wanted.
Put it mildly, that is so frustrating because that signifies there's a drive going on. You're in good spot, great place to run some of your best offense. Instead, they turn the ball over.
In trouble, and the ball's out. It's in the end zone, loose.
Get your ass out.
So it goes
good. Fuck.
The key thing.
In the game. And in this case, they were able to retain possession.
Now Carr throwing on second down. And Roberts with it over the middle. 6 yards is the pickup, and that'll lead to a third down.
One thing I can say pretty safely, that route is not called if you don't have a guy who can throw the ball and put some mustard on it. Because if you're going to lollipop it in the middle of the field,
ooh, that shit. Fuck.
It takes a strong.
Why you throw that shit so high? I know I'm not playing this shit, man.
You know it's not an easy job to go out and catch passes when people are trying to tackle you and knock the ball away. But the bottom line is, that's a pass he's got to have and a pass he should have caught.
One score down. Here we go. They're going to go for it here on fourth down.
All right, here we go.
Now Carr, got to have this one. And that's complete to Walford. And he's able to get this one all the way past the 30. Give him 25 yards on the play there. And they're able to move the chains as they convert on fourth and long. And now a first down following that long gain. And on the outside, they're playing press coverage. They come out here in the eye. On first down, Murray. And brought down, but not before reaching the 45-yard line. That one goes for 13 yards, and it moves the sticks.
But how many times do we say in this game that speed kills, and it does it in so many different ways? In this case, you got a back who's quick and shifty, can make moves, make people miss, but also gets to and through a hole before it can close down. That's some of the benefits of that speed, not just outrunning people in the secondary, and that led to a really nice game.
And he is in. Touchdown, Raiders. Michael Crabtree, 55 yards. And the Raiders have moved out in front here in the fourth quarter. And nothing too crazy there. A quick slant, and then he just had a seam. He found a seam.
And when you hit it on the run like that, and I mean the pass right to the receiver who's already in motion and moving, sometimes he just takes it and runs away from everyone else.
And he ran it into the end zone. And the defense, right, they've got to adjust there quickly. That's tough on them.
That's really tough because everything was executed well. Ball is out of his hands quickly into the hands of the receiver, and then he was gone.
So they make the decision. They want a three-point lead versus a two-point lead, and they got it.
Yeah, at this stage of the game, it seems like the exact right thing to do. Put a little pressure on your defense, but the biggest thing now is you're making the other team chase you.
Now Janikowski following the score. He'll boot this one away. This is taken at his four. And he'll take this across the 25. A couple extra yards up to the 27-yard line. So out come the Chargers. And the last time they had the football, they surrendered 2 points on the safety. They don't want to do that one again.
No, not at all. It's almost like a bases clearing double, isn't it? Give up a couple of runs.
Sure.
just messes things up for you offensively. But now they've got to go ahead, take it, set it aside, and move forward.
He's brought down that time by a couple of Raiders.
The best defensive linemen, they play with great leverage so they can get low and not get bowled over by offensive linemen. They have excellent hands. They can throw people off on a play. We just saw a great example of a really good run stop by a guy playing the defensive tackle position.
And he'll be out of bounds across the 30-yard line. 4 yards on the completion, and it sets up a third down. He's been a busy man here in this one, and they're showing off some nice footwork to stay in bounds.
And with those types of catches and the volume that we've seen in this game, wouldn't you keep him busy as well?
I would.
Of course. You got to keep throwing it to him. He keeps making plays.
Now Rivers. And it's complete. Henry. And he will have first down yardage as he's brought down at the 41. They're going to hurry back to the line now. Looking to jam the receivers at the line here. Press coverage look defensively. They go play action here on first down. And right side, Henry's got it. Give him 9 there on the first down completion.
Seeing that play and understand just how tough it is to cover tight ends, especially the ones running around the NFL nowadays, makes me glad I didn't make it in that league. I would have had a really difficult time.
But now you get to sit up here with me.
Yeah, that's fun, isn't it? And what a really nice game right there on first down for them. Brings up a nice second down for them.
Here comes the D swarming to the line. On second down, they'll run with Gordon. And he'll get it down here to the 43. Time for a break. 7 yards there, good enough to move the sticks. We'll come back for the electrifying conclusion after this. First down and 10 now for the offensive group. Now a play fake here on first down. And his throw One man in the backfield is Gordon. Back to throw. He completes it to Henry. That throw good for only a couple. It brings up third down. Seventh play of the drive, forthcoming on third and 8. And now they're in the hurry up.
Well, the strategy was evident there. Get it to your tight end and make it a one-on-one play with a cornerback. Who's usually going to win that one?
The tight end, but not there.
Not in this situation. How about the corner defeating that logic and making a really
roughing the passer?
So
what
the
fuck?
15-yard penalty.
And you notice how the offensive line responded. A couple went to check on the quarterback, and a couple went to the guy who hit the quarterback. No one likes to see their quarterback hit.
Fresh set of downs here. They'll come out in the pistol. Back to throw. And he's going to drop this off to his fullback. And he'll go down here at the 12-yard line. It's an 8-yard pickup, and it'll make it a second down. Looking to speed things up here, going with some tempo. They come out here in the eye. Rivers going to turn and give this one to his running back, Gordon. Only a yard on the pickup, so a good situation on second and two. It's now third and one.
Partner, we know today's NFL is really built around the guy throwing the football. But these short runs, they still pay dividends because they can take their toll on a defense and they can add up as the game goes along. You control the clock, you control the ball, and that way you often control the game.
They give them 2 yards there as they're set up now with a first and goal.
Third and one, partner. No need to be fancy there. Just use some force and move forward and pick up the first down.
First down and goal. The offense knocking on the door. And they'll lose yardage here. They go backwards to the 13-yard line. That's going to go as a loss of 4, and it'll be second down. Well, just play after play after play on this long drive for the offense. One receiver left. That's Allen. He's back to throw. That's going to be caught at the 10-yard line. And the ball is knocked out. And the Raiders pick it up.
Woo. That's game, boy. You play good, though, man. You play good. Oh, you about to quit? Don't quit the game, nigga. Don't quit. Oh, you sorry. What you going to challenge, nigga? It's under 2 minutes.
So one more chance to stop the clock here, and we'll be back. Ship together here from the D-line. They come out here in the eye. Carr going to look to throw. He's going to fire one deep, middle of the field. And incomplete there. A nice hit. Jars the ball free and brings up third down. Incomplete pass on second down. Let's see what the offense draws up here on third. To throw his car. He's just going to dump this one off to his fullback out of the backfield. And play is stopped here. Timeout. It's the defense calling the timeout here. That'll be their third and final stoppage here as we step aside. Looks like the defense in press coverage here. Take that for granted, no matter who you're playing, no matter where you're playing.
You take it and you run with it. And you know you primed the pump all week in your own home facility. No one thinks
should've
we
took
can
that
do
field
this.
Goal, man.
Only people who believe are right here in this room. And then you go on the road, band together, and get it done.
So that'll just about do it for Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gordon. You've been watching the NFL on EA Sports. For more, log on to EASports.com.
Yeah. For timeshare?
From San Diego.
How long do timeshare last? For how long?
Until you sell it, or if you lose it because you don't.
So you mean tell me I pay $100 for a timeshare and I got it for life?
Yeah, you get that week. You get that. That's what it's called, timeshare. You get that week. You pay your maintenance fees. Like I was just explaining to Charles, I think what we all should do is try to buy one and get there or Lake Arrowhead and try to do that this year.
And what, we only get 1 week?
Yeah.
Who we could use a week, like, periodically? Like, I could do one day and then come back the next year for another day?
No, just use the 1 week, and then the next year, you use the week again.
That's what I'm asking, like, how one long week. Do I have? I, one
it's
week a year.
1 week a year or 1 week every other year, depending on which one you decide. The reasons why you would want to probably do 1 week every other year is you only pay maintenance fees every other year.
Okay, so what are the maintenance fees?
It depends on the timeshare. And so usually I search on that, like mine at the Welp, mm-hmm. is about $600 or some a year.
Dang. You got to pay that all at once, or do you pay that on like installments?
You can pay it all at once, but what you can do is pay it when you do it.